Assalamualaikum everyone. You all are welcome to NASRA Public School Online Teaching System. Welcome to Grade 9 and 10 Physics class. In today's class, we will be solving all the problems related to the chapter Measurement and will also discuss solved example. Previously, we have learned about error and their types. An error is defined as the difference between the measured and the actual value. If two persons use the same instruments for performing the same measurements, they will not necessarily come up with the same result. There are three types of errors: personal, systematic, and random error. Personal error belongs to the person who is performing the experiment. A random error is also called accidental error. This arises due to experimental conditions. And systematic error is due to fault in the measuring instrument and is usually called zero error. Accuracy is the measurement of quantities involved in a phenomenon as close to the actual value as possible. There are two types of relation of proportionality: indirect proportion. As one number increases, so does the other. In inverse proportion, it's exactly the opposite. As one number increases, the other decreases. Before starting new topic, let's have a look at students' learning outcomes of this lesson. By the end of the lesson, students will be able to solve numerical, including area and volume problems, and do conversion of units, centimeter to meter or kg to gram, and so on. First, we will discuss some solved examples and then solve some questions. Measurements. Find the surface area of the sphere and express the answers in significant figures. Formula of surface area is A is equal to 4 pi r square, from which we have given with the radius of sphere, which is 0.20 centimeter, and the value of pi is constant, which is equal to 3.142. Putting these values, we get 0.50272. Rounding it off, 2 is less than 5, so we simply drop it. 7 is greater than 5, so when we drop it, we add 1 to its next number, which is 2 here. After adding 1, it becomes 3. Now, as 3 is also less than 5, so we drop it, and now we are left with 0.50. This is our required answer. Find the volume of a rectangular box whose dimensions are given below. L equal to 2.00 centimeter, B equal to 1.5 centimeter, and H is equal to 1 centimeter. To find volume, we know that the formula of volume is L multiplied by B multiplied by H. We have all these three values, so start putting the given values in formula. We get V equal to 2 multiply by 1.5 multiply by 1, which is equal to 3, and the unit of volume is centimeter cube. Look at the given dimensions L, B and H. All of these are given in centimeter. When we multiply centimeter 3 times, it becomes centimeter cube. A steel rod has a diameter of 2.52 centimeter. Express its diameter in millimeters and meter. See that diameter is given in centimeter, which is 2.52 centimeter. We have to convert it in millimeter and meter. 1 centimeter is equal to 10 millimeter. So for 2.52 centimeter, it will be equals to 2.52 multiplied by 10 is equal to 25.2 millimeter. For meters, 1 centimeter is equal to 1 divided by 100 meter. So for 2.52 centimeter, it will be equals to 2.52 multiplied by 1 divided by 100, which is 0.0252 meter. Don't forget to write correct units in your answer. The mass of an electron is 9.11 exponent minus 31 kg. Convert it in gram, milligram and microgram. We have given the mass in kg. For conversion, we need to know it's stable to convert it easily. If 1 kg is equal to 10 cube gram, so then 9.11 exponent minus 31 kg will be 9.11 exponent minus 31 multiplied by 10 cube. We simply multiply 9.11 exponent minus 31 with 10 cube. 10 cube is also be written as 1000. We get 9.11 exponent minus 20 gram is equals to 10 cube milligram. So we use the value in grams to convert it in milligram. 9.11 exponent minus 28 multiply by 10 cube. We get 9.11 exponent minus 25 milligram. We can use calculator for this exponent multiplication, but here is how we can calculate it without calculator. For example, look for the conversion of milligram. 9.11 exponent minus 28 multiply by 10 cube. See that we have same basis exponent, so we can easily write the number 9.11 as it is, and exponent will like as in multiplication. When we have same basis, we sum up their powers, so we will do same here. We have basis 10, so we solve their powers and write the exponent ones. Here the powers are minus 28 and plus 3. So minus 28 plus 3 will be minus plus is equal to minus. 28 minus 3 is equal to 25. It will be minus 25 because 28 is greater with negative sign. 9.11 exponent minus 25 milligram is the required answer. The radius of hydrogen atom is 0.53 exponent minus 10 meter. Convert it in centimeter, millimeter and nanometer. Given radius is 0.53 exponent minus 10 meter. We know that 1 meter is equals to 100 centimeter, or it can be written as 10 square centimeter. So if 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter, we can say that 0.53 exponent minus 10 multiplied by 10 square centimeter. Writing 0.53 as it is and calculating the exponent, we have powers minus 10 and plus 2. Minus plus is equal to minus. 10 minus 2 is equals to 8. The sign will be of 10, which is negative. So it will be minus 8. It becomes 0.53 exponent minus 8 centimeter. For millimeter, 1 meter is equals to 10 cube millimeter, means 1 meter is equal to 1000 millimeter. Multiplying 0.53 exponent minus 10 multiplied by 10 cube. Calculating exponents, minus 10 plus 3, it will be minus 7. So the answer is 0.53 exponent minus 7. Assignment for today's class: do solved example 2.4 in your copy. Complete numerical number 2 and 3, remaining conversions. Do numerical number 4, hint numerical 4. For conversion of seconds to minutes, divide it by 60, and in conversion of seconds to hours, divide it by 3600. That is all for this class. Thank you.